This is a note about an article that we just talked about. I don't have time to read this article right now, but I want to read this article later when I have time. I want to create a to-read list. To create the to-read list, I need to use a plugin. Let's go to Setting, Community Plugin, and Browse. I want to use a plugin called DataView. Right here, select it, install, enable, and then close this window. And then we go back to our to-read list. To create this to-read list, I need to add a file property. I need to add tags. I want to add a tag called to-read. So I'm tagging this note as an article that I want to read later. How can I make that article automatically show up here? We need to write a simple code, very simple. Right-click, insert, code block. Here we say data view, and I want to create a list from all the nodes that include the hashtag to read. This is the code, but the result is not showing up because we're having this reading view. If I click it, then this article with the tag to read list is showing up. If I move my mouse there, the content of that node is also showing up. What about I also want to add this article to my to read list? Add file property tag to read because I've already created. Let's go to read list to see if the new article is showing up there. Go to source mode. Here you go. So my to read list is automatically updated. I can also add a new tag to read and then go to read list and change the view. Here you go. That's how I created my own to read list. Use the same method. I created a glossary. This is the glossary that I created. All this is under the code and it's automatically updated. This is the name of the note. And in this note, this is my note, term, double colon, concept. And my new note, and it's connected to concept and definition. And this is a citation and the reference. We also have term, construct, the definition. Now, if I go to glossary, this is the glossary that I created. Everything here is automatically updated. I have first column as note. These are my note name. Those are the terms, and these are the definition of the terms. And in this note, adaptive decision making, it has a definition of adaptive decision making and situational awareness. And this is the definition of adaptive decision making. And this is the definition of situational awareness. To create this automatically updated glossary, we need to do two things. First, in the note, I need to have a very specific structure. I first write term, double colon, and then add the term that I wanted to add the definition. This is the same thing, term, situational awareness, and then definition, double colons. Now, let's go to the code that I wrote for glossary. I use DataView, and I wanted to create a table without the ID of the file, but I wanted my table has three columns, note, term, and definition. This is why in my note, I have a very specific structure. I also want to sort this term in ascending order. So this is the code I wrote. Oh, one more thing, because this node has the tag define. I have define quotes. So adding tags actually are very helpful. This is actually an article. It also includes quote, and it's related to neuroscience and use QEEG, which is one of the approach we measure brain waves. I also use a similar method, created Quotebook. In my Quotebook, I have the note name and I also have the quote and then also the page number, the source and page number. If I go to this article, Cardinal Sins and Misdemeanors of Management Science, my quote is here. Don't worry about this call out box right here. Quote, double columns, putting your quote there. And also I added the tag quote in my quote book. If you look at my quote, it's very similar. I wanted to create a table without the node ID, but I wanted two columns. One is a quote where it contains tags, and I want to sort the node in descending order. And this is how I created Quotebook. One last thing. I prefer to use dark screen because I feel dark screen is easier for my eye. To change the setting from light screen to dark screen, you go to Setting, Appearance, Base Color Scheme, Adapt to System, you choose dark screen. I hope this tutorial is helpful for your note-taking and your research process.